Karen Oberhauser. Ask her anything about monarch butterflies, and she'll probably know the answer. She's been observing them for a very long time. She's a biologist at the University of Minnesota, where she conducts research about monarchs and conservation biology. Conservation biology is the study of how to best protect the many living things on Earth and their habitats. On a quest to better understand monarchs, Karen has enlisted university students to work with her in the laboratory and in the field. Together, they're busy designing investigations to learn about the health of the monarch population. But as fast as these students move, they can only cover so much ground. They need help from a trained army of scientists in the field. That's where citizen scientists come in. Citizen scientists of all ages are trained to identify and record the number of monarch eggs, caterpillars, and adult butterflies they see. These people become the eyes, ears, and reporters for research projects, helping scientists like Karen accomplish much more than they could on their own. With the help from citizen science data, Karen has learned about monarch survival and the potential effects of climate change on these interesting insects. Meet Rob Blair. He became a citizen scientist at age 8 when he began observing birds. Eventually, he began participating in the long-running annual Audubon Christmas bird count. Citizen scientists have been part of the Audubon count for over 100 years. They used to mail postcards of their tallies to the Audubon Society. Now, they submit their tallies online. The information they've gathered about birds through the years has helped scientists better understand populations of birds across North America. Rob grew up to be an ornithologist, which is someone who studies birds. He now works as a scientist at the University of Minnesota, where he studies birds in urban areas. Citizen scientists have been making observations for a long time. In 1776, Thomas Jefferson organized citizen scientists across a new America. They sent their notes to him by horseback. Weather, birds, butterflies, and that's just the beginning. Citizen scientists observe all sorts of things. And if you want to observe really, really big things, citizen scientists look far away into outer space. Some amateur astronomers, citizen scientists, have even discovered gigantic things like comets and supernovas. All of these projects help scientists like Karen and Rob answer important questions about nature and the universe. But beyond that, another really cool thing about citizen science is that you can ask your own questions. Be your own scientist, and there's almost no limit to where you can go. I wonder, what will you discover?